Muft. Oh, brothers, your prayer is not valid. Oh, why? Because you don't pray Fatiha behind the Imam. Well, brother, if our prayer is not valid, then the prayers of Sahaba is not valid even. And if their prayer is not valid, who are you? Who are you? But brother, subhanAllah, we are living in very difficult times. People love confusing. People love criticizing. And people love dividing on the name of Quran and Sunnah. But they are really spreading ignorance and hatred. That is not the way of Islam. So I was saying in Surah Fatiha, when you pray behind the Imam, you remain silent, you listen to Imam, even if you can't hear. Like in Zuhr and Asr, Imam is still reciting on your behalf, so you remain quiet, whether it's Fajr, whether it's Zuhr, whether Asr, Maghrib, Isha, whichever Salat, let the Imam Sahib recite, inshallah he can recite better. MashaAllah, Qari Sahib recites good, let him recite on your behalf, he is praying for you as well. In Surah Fatiha, there is a dua, and that dua is, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Ya Allah, show us the right path. We need food to eat, we need drink, tea, coffee, whatever juices people drink, MashaAllah. Coke, Pepsi, I'm not a Mufti, so don't ask me to give fatwa whether Coke is halal or haram. You can ask the Mufti sahab afterwards. MashaAllah. But we drink also, MashaAllah, juices. Allah has made all these things for us. MashaAllah, fruits and nice things to eat and enjoy. Wear clothes, MashaAllah. Ya bani Adam, qad anzalna alaykum libasan yuwari sawatikum warisha. People wear clothes, MashaAllah. This distinguishes humans from animals. One day, mashallah, you see lions, they have the same fur throughout their lives. Birds have the same feathers throughout their lives. Parrots, mashallah, very colorful birds. Cheetah, spotted animal. Tigers, mashallah, stripes. The same thing, you can tell a cheetah, tiger, lion, giraffe, elephant from miles. Because they look, they have a special appearance. But mashallah, one day, you come wearing different clothes. When you go to a wedding, mashallah, kya ho gaya janab, aaj to aap aise aa gaye jaise aapki shaadi hai. Mashallah. As though you are getting married, mashallah, but don't worry, it's not your wedding, brother, somebody else is getting married. Mashallah, you one day you wear some other clothes, the next day some other clothes, mashallah. At home, you relaxed in whatever. When you go out to work, different clothes, sleeping clothes, mashallah. People in this country, there are different things for everything. Sleeping suits, mashallah. And other things, mashallah. But libas of taqwa, piety. Wa libasu taqwa, zalika khair. People wear all sorts of things. But Muslims should wear dress and clothing which reflects piety, taqwa, decency, goodness. You can tell, mashallah, this brother is a pious, humble, practicing brother. Many people, they come to the masjid wearing t-shirts and three quarters in the summer. Mashallah, we're supposed to be in spring now, but mashallah, Allahu Akbar. In the summer when they come wearing t-shirt, when they go into sajda, the person praying behind them gets a free show. You don't come in to get a free show, brother. Astaghfirullah, people have come to the masjid to pray. They don't want a free show in the masjid. Subhanallah. Walibasu taqwa dhalika khair. Mashallah, your dress should represent modesty, taqwa, haya, in a good way. So we need clothes, we need houses, mashallah, we need cars to drive, but more than anything else, mashallah, brothers need wives, you need a good wife to have a good life. Men need wives, women need husbands, mashallah, then parents, they want children, but more than anything else, we all need hidayah. We have to pray to Allah for hidayah. How many times? 32 times minimum a day. 5 times prayer, but in each prayer, in Fajr you will pray at least 4 rakats. You will pray 4 rakats, in Zohr you will pray at least 10 rakats. 4 rakats sunnati muakkida, then 4 faraz, then 2 sunnati muakkida. And then Zohr you will pray at least 4 faraz, Maghrib at least 5, 3 faraz, 2 sunnahs. Then in Isha at least 9, 4 faraz, 2 sunnah, 3 witr, mashallah. And in Nafil on top, mashallah, there is no limit. But these are faraz, wajib and sunnati muwakkida. In every rakat, you either Imam Sahib will pray, or if you pray on your own, then you will recite Surah Fatiha. You will ask Allah to give you hidayah. Not just ask, we need to beg Allah. We are beggars. We are all beggars in front of Allah. Ya ayyuha an-nas antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. Oh, you people, doesn't matter who you are. Pakistanis, Bengalis, Indians, Arabs, Somali, Algerians, British, American, Europeans, Africans, we are all beggars in front of Allah. Ya ayyuha an-nas antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. Oh, you people, you are all beggars of Allah. So beg Allah. Many people beg other people. But really, we ought to beg from? Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Thee alone we worship, Ya Allah. We alone, Thee alone we ask for help, Ya Allah. Help us. Help us. What's the best help? Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Ya Allah, guide us all to the right path. We need to ask Allah, we need to beg Allah, and not just ask. Then we need to want it as well. Sometimes people just ask, but they don't really care. They just do it ritually. We have to want it from here. And Allah looks at what's in here. We can only see the appearance, mashallah. Nice suit, nice looking guy, mashallah. And suited, booted, mashallah. Clean shaven, mashallah. Brothers, everybody put your hands up. Both hands up, mashallah. You know, in class, the teacher says, put one hand up. I say, put both hands up. Both hands up, mashallah. Put your hands on your face now. And roll them down, roll, slowly, not like this, from the side. Roll it down, slowly, slowly, don't worry, inshallah. Roll it down, and then try to grab something. If you can grab, say, Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
If you can't, say, Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. Why? This is also sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mashallah, brother, this is sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is nothing better than the sunnah of Rasulullah. People like looking smart. Anybody here not want to look smart? People like looking smart. They get up in the morning, straight to the bathroom, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. Why? You want to look smart, man. You want to look smart. You know who was the most smartest man ever to walk on this earth? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There was no one more smart ever than Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, Ahsanu minka lam tara qattu aynan. Ya Rasulullah, no eye has ever seen anyone more handsome than you. There hasn't been ever any man better looking than Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And how could anybody be better looking? How could any eye ever see anyone better looking than Rasulullah? وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. No woman ever gave birth to anyone better than Rasulullah. No one was better than Rasulullah. خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. He was created so wonderful by Allah, as though Allah made him the way he wanted to be made. Aisha radiallahu anha, she says, the women of Egypt, you know when they saw Yusuf alayhi salam, Rasulullah said, oh, the beauty Allah has put in this world, Allah gave half to only Yusuf. When people want to get married, man, they say, you know, Mawlana Nasab, you know, some beautiful girl, inshallah, you know, I'm ready. Women like to marry handsome young men, mashallah. No problem, but we should give preference to piety. And the Prophet said, when people get married, especially women, when people want to marry women, tunkahul maratu li arba, for four reasons, li maliha, wa li jamaliha, wa li hasabiha, wa li diniha. Some people want to marry rich women. And they say, you know, Mawlana, if you know any nice, good-looking, rich girl, let me know, inshallah. They're supposed to provide for the girl, and they want the girl to provide for them. They want to retire after getting married. So some people marry, they want to marry a rich girl. Some people want to marry a girl from a good family, so that the family will provide. Keep coming, mansalwa. Sometimes people want to marry women for good looks. But the Prophet said, fazfur bidhati deen, I should look for piety. Piety will increase. Even if you marry Miss World, she's Miss World now, but 5-6 years, especially if you have one or two children, she won't be Miss World anymore. 30-40 years down the line, definitely no. Allahu Akbar. And you marry someone rich, they can lose it. The family won't be around for long. MashaAllah, 20-30-40 years down the line, the family will be gone. But you marry somebody pious, and inshallah, every day they will become better. They will look after you, they will look after themselves, they will be good to you in this world, and Allah will benefit them, you through them, inshallah, in Jannah as well. In Jannah as well. And people look for beauty. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah gave him such beauty. When Yusuf alayhi salam was growing up and Zulekha was in the same house, she would see Yusuf every day. She couldn't hold her feelings back anymore. And then she just became crazy about him. And in our language, in Punjabi, any Punjabi sitting here? No Punjabi sitting here? In Punjabi, there is a sher, there is a bit of poetry. There are two things you can't hide. Do cheezan chupaya maine chup diya. Ek ishq te dusra mushk. There's two things you can't hide. One is ishq. If you love him with someone, man, he's lost it. You can tell, man, his the way he looks, he's worried. He's in a world of his own. He's sitting here, coming to the masjid, but thinking about something else. If you put some nice itar on, you think you can hide it. Wherever you go, you leave a trail of nice, mashallah. You leave a nice trail. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah had blessed him in such a way. You know, when most other people sweat, they give off B.O. You know B.O.? Body odor. Sweats and smell. But when Rasulullah would sweat, Allahu Akbar, Rasulullah's perspiration, it was so fragrant. And the wives of Rasulullah would gather them, the perspiration, a sweat of Rasulullah stored in bottles, and that was more fragrant than even the most fragrant musk. Sahaba could tell Rasulullah has gone by the street, because that street will continue smelling good because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would walk through, and they would know Rasulullah has been. Rasulullah, wherever he went, he left a trail of goodness. Kadam kadam pe barkatein, nafas nafas pe rahmatein, jahan jahan se wo shafi'e aasiyan guzar gaya. Jahan nazar nahi padi, wahan hai raat aaj tak. Wahi sahar hui, jahan jahan guzar gaya. Every step Rasulullah took, wherever he went, whoever he saw, whoever looked at him, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left a trail of goodness, noor and barakah and hidayat. Wherever Rasulullah didn't go and didn't see, his message hasn't reached. Although the sun rises, but as though the world is still dark over there. Rasulullah, he was a real prophet of Allah. He was a real prophet of Allah. Khatamun Nabiyeen, Rahmatul Lil Alameen, Sayyidul Awwaleen Wal Akhireen, Shafi'ul Mudhnibeen. Allah is Rabbul Alameen. Rasulullah was Rahmatul Lil Alameen. Real prophet of Allah. He left a trail of goodness. There was another imposter. His name was Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani, Lanatullahi Alayh. When we mention about pious people,